Welcome to this short tutorial on installing Lansweeper. This video covers the advanced install. Performing an advanced install is recommended if one of the following is true. You have a network of more than 1,000 assets. You want to install a database under Microsoft SQL Server. You want to spread out your Lansweeper servers, database and web console over several machines. You want to configure an installation with multiple scanning servers. Okay, let's start the installation. Once you've downloaded the latest installer from our website and you run it on the machine, you'll be greeted by our setup wizard. So first things first, just click next and make sure you read the license agreement. Once you've completed that, you can just simply click on I agree. And then you'll be asked to either select a easy install or an advanced install. We're gonna go for our advanced install here. Now some additional options will pop up at the bottom. So you'll see both, you have the choice for going for the SQL Server or SQL Compact. Since you're doing an advanced install, you'll most likely want to do an SQL Server install. And then you can also select individual components. If you're spreading out your installations, for example, over different machines, you can only install a database or only install a service or only install a website. That's up to you. And once you click next, you'll be asked to log in to the database. So in this case, we have a local database set up and we can use Windows authentication, but obviously you can also use SQL Server authentication and select a different database if it is hosted somewhere else. In this case, we'll be going with Windows authentication. And once you click next, it will connect to the database and retrieve some basic information. Next up, you'll be able to choose the configuration for your Lansweeper website. The recommended will use IIS Express, but you have the option to select Advanced and use IIS as your web hosting service. When you use IIS Express, you get the option to choose both your HTTP and HTTPS port. When you select Advanced, you'll only be asked to enter an HTTP port. Simply because for IIS, you'll have to configure HTTPS in IIS itself. Once you've selected your preferred web hosting service, simply click Next. Then you have a option to select your install folder. So if you want to install Lansweeper in a custom folder on a different drive, you can do it here. And then once you click Install, the Lansweeper installation will start running and will install Lansweeper completely. Once the installation has completed, you can click on Finish. And once you navigate to the web console, you'll be greeted by this, first run wizard. The first thing it'll ask you is for either your email if you do not have a license key, so we can send you a license key and you can unlock your installation. Or if you already have a license key, you can click on the checkbox here and simply insert it. For this webinar, we'll simply use one of our license keys that we have. There we go. So next we'll be starting the configuration of Lansweeper in the first run wizard. The first thing I'll ask you is which IP ranges you'd like to scan. This is based on the subnets that the machine that you've installed Lansweeper on is located on. On this machine, you know, there's only one subnet, so only one IP range that we can select. But if there is multiple, you can select them or deselect them, as you can see. Then next up, we have all the different types of scanning targets that are in Lansweeper. So you could simply select them all or leave it to the default ones. You know, most likely you'll select the scanning targets for the devices that you have in your network. So if you do not have, for example, if you do not have vCenter, then you can just leave it out. Or, you know, if you have AWS or Azure in there, then, you know, be sure to check those. Just to kind of go through everything, I'll select all of them now so you can see everything. One last thing on this page is if you want more information about the scanning target or the type of devices, you can also just hover over the question mark and you'll get some more information as well as a link to our knowledge base, which has additional information such as requirements or how you'd scan them within Lansweeper as well. So on this page, you'll get some general info about the credentials. For example, you know, why are the credentials needed? Obviously, you'll need credentials to retrieve the data. Otherwise, you know, we'll only get, you know, some very basic information. But for the details that you like to get, you need credentials. It's simply that. And for the security, all the passwords are encrypted with a unique key that is, unique to your installation. So it's fully secured. Then next up, we'll be going through all the different asset types and their credentials. Again, if you want more information, then there's always a question mark at the top that links to the knowledge base article that has all the information about what type of credentials it needs to be, what the permissions need to be, etc. So for example, here in the Windows, it's already detected our username because it's taken the username from this computer. For the password, I'll just simply fill in the password here. For Windows, just make sure it's local. The account has local administrative permissions. I won't go into many details for the other assets. As I mentioned, if you want the information, it's always available to find exactly what you need. And for things like network devices, this would be an SNMP community that's quite standardized, so usually that's public. It could also be private, but private is usually used for read and write access, so this is pretty default. If you have a different SNMP community, then fill it in there. We're going to skip vCenter for now and ESXi. I'm just skipping them because I've given the example earlier, so you know what to do here. So these credentials, you can add them in the first run wizard, but if you select them and skip them anyway, then you can always fill them in later in the credentials area of Lansweeper. So now that we've entered our credentials and clicked on the final button, now you can see that our scan is actually starting. So you'll see some scan statistics as well as the scanning queue on the right side. This page will automatically close after a short time, but you can also just click on finish to continue on to the dashboard. The scan will continue, and meanwhile we're going to take a look at what's already been retrieved. We'll head over to the assets tab where you can see all the assets that have already been pulled in. We'll navigate to one of the Windows assets here. As you can see, there's a lot of information that's already been retrieved here. Obviously, this is just the tip of the iceberg, and there's much, much more to discover. You can find more information below to help you set up Lansweeper and discover everything it has to offer. Check out these other videos, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.